for the problem. So now let's talk about what work is, okay? Because in the work energy approach, you have two quantities. You have work and you have energy. So let's define what work really is. So probably from your high school physics class, as well as maybe Mech 101, if you took it here or an equivalent class somewhere else, you know the definition of work applied on a particle by a force F as force times the displacement. So the work you have probably seen defined as the force times the displacement. And there's nothing wrong with this definition, except that there are certain conditions that you have to remember when you use an equation of this sort. The number one condition is that this force should be in the direction of displacement, which means that if I have the same particle and I apply the force F at an angle, let's say this angle is alpha, and it is displaced by the same amount D as before, the work done is no longer equal to the force times displacement. So notice that this force F over here is nothing but the magnitude of this force, okay? So the work done is not F times D. Perhaps you are saying that, hey, this is actually equal to the component of this force F along the direction of displacement, which is F times cosine alpha times D. And if you're saying that, then that would actually be correct. So essentially what we are saying is that the work done is equal to force times displacement only if the force is aligned with the direction of displacement. Okay, if it is not aligned with the direction of displacement, then you cannot use that force. Alright, so this is your high school level definition of work, right? In engineering dynamics, we have a much more formal definition for the work. So let's say we have a particle moving along a curved path in general, okay? And there is a certain force F applied on this particle, alright? In delta t amount of time, in a very small amount of time, let's say this particle is displaced by a differential vector dr. Okay, and differential vector dr is always going to be tangent to the path, because we know velocity is defined as dr over dt. This is a scalar quantity, this is a vector quantity, and this is a vector quantity. So clearly the direction of dr would be same as direction of v, right? So dr is always tangent to the path. So in a small amount of time, under the application of this force F, the particle is displaced by differential vector dr, then the work done by this force over this displacement is given by F dot dr. So this dot is really dot product. So when you take dot product of two vectors, that's what this dot over here is, okay? Now this is the work which is done over a small differential displacement. So this work is called differential work, which we call dw, okay? So this is a small amount of work done over a small displacement. So if you want to compute the total work done, maybe in taking this particle from position P1 to P2, then the total work done would be obtained by integrating dw, okay, over this path, which we'll call, let's say, C. So this becomes a line integral. So that is integral F dot dr. So if you took a math class in your freshman year, then you learned about line integrals, right? Where you could integrate a function over a certain path. So if you know the path, then you can compute what this line integral would be, okay? And that is basically the definition of the work. So if somebody now asks you, how do you define the work? You should always say, it's line integral F dot dr, all right? Now, what is F, what is dr? Well, that would depend on what the problem is. So F always depends on the nature of interaction, and dr is something that you would know from the path, right? So in general, if let's say in Cartesian system, F is given as F sub x I hat plus F sub y j hat, and this is just in the xy plane, and r, the position vector with respect to some coordinate system. So let me show this oxy, and this is the position of the particle. So r is given as x I hat plus y j hat, which means that dr, differential vector, would be dx I hat plus dy j hat, okay? So what is w? W is integral dw, and from now onward, I won't really necessarily write C to indicate it's a line integral. You just have to know that it is actually a line integral. So now let's substitute for F and R here. So F is this, and d dot dr is, so if we integrate, if we take the dot product, we get fx dx, I dot j is 0, j dot I is 0, so we are left with just this, right? So that's the total work done. Okay, and in Cartesian system, that's how we can compute the work done by a force, right? Now let's look at some special cases, okay? So special cases. So definition of the work is integral dw, which is integral f dot dr, okay? So number one special case is when dr is equal to 0. So what does that mean? It means that there is no displacement, which means that if a particle is at rest somewhere and it is not moving under the application of a force, then the work done by that force will be actually 0, right? So when dr is 0, that means the work would be 0, okay? All right, if or when f is perpendicular to dr, then also work done would be 0. Why? Because this is a dot product over here, right? So f dot dr is equal to norm of f times norm of dr times cosine of the angle between the two. So if f is perpendicular to dr, then the angle between the two vectors will be 90, and that means cosine of 90, because it's 0, will give you work to be 0 as well. So when does this happen? Well, let's look at an example. I have my particle, all right, and I'm applying a force F on it, let's say perpendicular to the ground line, and that is the direction of displacement along the ground, right? So in this case, F and dr are perpendicular to each other, and that means that the work done will be 0, okay? Now, in this case, you might say, hey, there's no way the particle is going to be actually displaced in the direction that is shown over here, because F is acting normal to it. You are right, that would be true, but you could have certain forces which would be acting perpendicular direction of displacement while the particle was moving. So for example, I could have the same particle, okay, and I could apply a force F in the direction of displacement, and this is dr, and clearly there will be work done by this force F, it won't be 0. But if you draw the free body diagram of this particle, so I'm going to draw it all by itself, you have the force F, you have the normal reaction, and you have gravity, right? So essentially there are three forces acting on this particle. You have N, you have mg, and you have F. F is doing work, but mg is perpendicular direction of displacement, so mg won't be doing any work. N is also perpendicular direction of displacement, so N won't be doing any work, right? So the forces that act in direction perpendicular to displacement at all times during their journey on the path will do no work, right? Let me give you another example of normal reactions not doing any work. So let's say we have a hoop, okay, hoop or ring, and this is in a vertical plane, and I have a slider which is free to slide on this vertical hoop, okay? And let's say, you know, I tie this with a spring at the center of this ring, all right? Now, what is the direction of displacement of this particle? It is tangent to this path, right? So let's say it's moving in this direction. So that's the direction of displacement. In fact, at all times, the direction of displacement would be tangent to this path, right? It cannot be anything else because it's constrained to move along this path. What are the forces acting on this particle? So if you draw a free body diagram, you have the spring forces, which are kx, you have the gravity acting downward, and you have the normal reaction, right? So this is the path, that's the circular path, and this is your dr vector, that's your tangential vector. N is always going to be perpendicular to dr, right? N is always perpendicular to dr, no matter where you see it. So the particle is here, after a while the particle may be here, dr is pointing this way, N is pointing that way, the particle may be here after a while, dr is pointing this way, N is pointing that way, and at all times the angle between these vectors is 90 degrees, right? And that means that the work done due to N is equal to 0. Could we say the same thing about mg? Not necessarily, because there is a component of mg along the tangential direction that is not zero. So there will be work done by mg, right? What about the work done by kx? Well, if kx is aligned in a way that it is pointing towards the center always, then kx is also perpendicular to dr at all times, right? Which means that the work done due to kx, or maybe I should call it work done due to elastic forces, will also be zero. But that's because of this particular choice of configuration of the spring. If the spring is not mounted at the center of this loop, let's say I'm mounted here. Okay, so this is how it is mounted. Right, if that's the case, then this line along which the kx or elastic forces act is not necessarily perpendicular to dr, right? That is not true necessarily. In that case, the work done due to elastic forces will not be zero, right? So we looked at some special cases when the work done could be equal to zero, right? And if you have never seen something like this before, you know, this may seem a little bit counterintuitive as to how, you know, the forces that act in direction perpendicular to displacement, you know, don't give rise to any work, okay? And you, maybe some of you are thinking about, you know, a simple exercise where you have, let's say, you know, your hand, okay? Your hand, and I'm not doing a very good job, in fact, it doesn't look like a hand, but let's say, and you have a hand, and you have, you know, something heavy on your hand, all right? I should probably learn some drawing, okay? And your job is to basically carry this around, all right? And somebody says, hey, you know, take this book and just keep it in a horizontal position, keep your arms stretched outward, and walk around for half an hour. And this is a very heavy object that you have in your hand, okay? And if you draw the free body diagram on this object, so I'm going to draw this all by itself, you have the weight, right? And then you have the normal reaction from your hand to support it, right? So according to the definition of the work, which is integral f dot dr, if f and dr are perpendicular to each other, then the work done is zero, right? And you are moving in horizontal direction, right? So that's your direction of displacement. So clearly both n and mg are not doing any work in this case, right? So work done due to n is zero and work done due to gravity is zero, right? But you are clearly doing some work because your hands get tired while you're walking with this heavy object in your hand. So what's going on here? Why are you getting tired if n is not doing any work, mg is not doing any work? Well, there's more to it, right? First of all, if you're supporting this book, so at the wrist, you are applying a torque, right, to keep it in place. So, you know, this is where the wrist joint is, this is where n is, this is where mg is going to exert a downward torque. So to counteract that, you have to apply a torque in the opposite direction to keep it in place, right? And the torque on your wrist is actually going to do some work, right? At the same time, you know, your hand is getting squished under the weight of this thing, right? So there is deformation in the vertical direction, right? And that's the force acting on your hand. At the same time, you're walking around, of course. If you look at the forces acting on your body, you have the friction forces acting on your feet. Of course, to walk, you have to do work, right? So sure enough, if you just look at N and MG, it looks like they're not doing any work, but there is overall work done by you in carrying this book around, right?